The symposium at the Vatican, which took place October 15th and 16th of this year, was at the invitation of the Vatican. Mm-hmm. We were given a completely free hand in inviting whomever we wished. I brought together two people that have distinct but complementary competencies. One who is a professor of economics and theology, former president of the Catholic Theological Society of America, Dan Finn, and the other, retired head of J.P. Morgan for 20 years in Switzerland and Belgium. So you have more or less academic sophistication and real-world practicality. And putting them together, and depending on them, I did very little, but depending on them to think through who would be the best people for this kind of conference that wanted to focus on Catholic social teaching as it applies to the United States, economics, and the Pope's latest encyclical, which came out in June of 2009 on the market and the economy. I turned it over to them. They invited 27 scholars, several from Europe, the rest from North America. We expected 15 to 16 to accept, no more. All but one accepted. And they all produced papers beforehand, and they all read the papers beforehand. And then we devoted all of our time, 6 2-hour sessions at the Vatican, to debate and discussion of the issues raised by the papers. There were several of them, some of them linked very much to the Pope's encyclical, of course, and others linked very much to the United States and its impact on globalization and development. I'll give you a couple of examples. Number one, one of the key issues, the Pope brings up the issue of gift. Now, obviously, you can't run an economy without exchange, you know. So gift, if all you do is ever give gifts, you run into problems. So if you relate it, the concept of gift to the poor, is the responsibility to the poor primarily a matter of charity, or is it a matter of justice? If you say it's a matter of charity, it's optional. Not only that, it has the potential of being condescending. If it's a matter of justice, then in fact, whose responsibility is it to enact that justice? Is it the government? And if it is the government, how do you do that? Entitlements? Welfare to work? There is no specific program that says you must do it this way or that way. But if there's not a combination of gift and justice, rather than either gift or justice, then I think you impoverish not only the poor, but you end up with a degree of confusion about what the moral responsibility is. That's one issue that was debated. A second issue, for example, that was debated was the relative absence in the encyclical of any attention to women. Now, we had a number of people who brought this up, who spoke about it, and particularly people who are deeply involved in the work of development, because they pointed out that there's study after study that shows that if you want to transform the economy of a country that is really poor, the single most crucial factor is the education of women and their impact on development. That makes a huge difference, and therefore there has to be that degree of commitment. So it may well be an area of future research, but those are a couple of areas that were raised. The Institute does have, I don't know if I would call it a point of view, mm-hmm. but it does have a deep commitment to a variety of areas. We've already entered deeply into interreligious dialogue, particularly with Muslims, Jews, and Christians. We've looked at issues of authority and subsidiarity. We have a volume coming out from Oxford on that subject. But we also are very interested in what are called the social teachings of the Church, Catholic social teachings. Very few people are unaware of what the Church teaches about abortion, about sex, about homosexuality. Not many people know what the Church teaches also about the constituents of a just economy. Not many people know what it teaches about immigration. And these are issues that are called generally the Catholic social teaching. And it's the important relationship between these two. It's already been documented that in many dioceses in the United States, the office for that has to do with abortion, mm-hmm. is over here, and the office that has to do with social justice is over here. Our concern is to make sure these are in regular communication with each other, so that abortion itself is seen as an issue of social justice, as well as care for women in crisis pregnancies, so on and so forth. So we have a deep interest in trying to get this Catholic social teaching embedded more in the life, the structure, the mindset of not just the Catholic population, but the larger population.